How many accidents in Tonga are caused by drunk drivers? How many young people have been abused by an alcoholic relative? Now, I'm not saying drinking is wrong. I'm saying alcohol abuse and alcoholism is what's wrong. And it is a problem around the world. And even in this country, that's supposed to be a Christian nation with strong cultures and tradition. And I also fear that there may be victims of alcohol abuse in this congregation. I close this sermon with a passage from the Bible in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 18. And it says, "Do not give way to drunkenness and the ruin that goes with it."
Thank you, Pastor.
Thank you for coming to church. Thank you for coming to church.
Let's go, Malo.
Hey, hey sir, man.
Oh, thanks, son. Yeah. Can we have a minute?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, but please take a seat.
How's it going, Pastor?
Good, good. Yes, you too. I'm just happy to see you attending church.
It's been a long time.
Yes, it has. Just thought I'd encourage you on the message that I preached today. And just thought I'd give you an encouragement and warning of the dangers of alcoholism.
Thanks, man.
And the danger that it poses on our culture. So keep it up, son. And I love you.
Future Fumble.
The Junkin' Master.
Hey, Bashi. Hey, come join us, man. Okay, why you loser?
Yeah.
He's a loser.
Yeah.
Father, your servants come before you, and I'd just like to ask you, God, that you protect my son and be with him when I'm gone.
I'm happy you guys are here at the Faikawa today. You know, this is how our ancestors passed on our history to our grandfathers and our fathers through our traditional kava ceremony. It's a good thing you guys are doing. You know, our ancestors, they were great warriors. They also traveled Oceania through big war canoes called the kalias. I should be proud of that. Learn our history. Learn of how they searched out different islands.
Push, push.
Whee! Woohoo!
Push. You want?
Boss, why you come in here? Disrespect our kava circle. Look at the pretty toa. Look at your friends over here, your cousins. You come in here and disrespect us.
Man. What are you going on about, old man? Talk too much. I'm here trying to have fun, you know? Brainwash these kids.
What happened to you? Look at you. Drinking again? You know, I know your grandfather and your father. They'd be very disappointed you come in here like this. Disrespectful to your family and your culture.
Man, you know what? Talk too much. This is a new culture. This is a new century, new generation. You talking about culture? You call this culture? This is my culture.
Boss, take your 21st century culture and leave. You have to get out. Hurry up. Get up and take your boys with you.
Man, I don't want to be here anyways. I'm out.
Okay, boy.
Okay.
Go away.
Out.
Boys, I'm glad you guys are here. See what Boss is doing? Drinking, getting drunk, not taking care of his family, his responsibilities. This is a good place for you guys to learn. Hey, and you, Tohi. Haven't you been here for 2 days? Haven't been home here to your family? Faikava is not a place to run away from your responsibilities. You need to get up and go home too. Hurry up.
Wake up.
What?
You know, my mother was an alcoholic and she was very abusive. She would go out drinking all night and and every time she comes home, she would give me and my little sisters beatings. And something. Well, you know how you guys drank last night, and I think you slept, and your boyfriend, he came into my room and he touched me.
What?
He did.
What?
He did.
No, you're lying.
Mom, I'm telling the truth.
You're trying to get him for yourself.
No, he came into my room.
Get up! I'm not done with you yet!
Ow. No! She ruined my family. That's what alcohol did. And look at what you're doing now.
You know what? I'm sorry. I'd like to apologize to my family, my wife, and especially my kids, who I love so much and was too stupid enough to realize that my actions play a big role in their life. You know, growing up, Dad, my parents always told me that in order to get something big in life, you must go through God and praise his name. I can't remember the last time I went to church. And I think I need to go back, change my ways, you know, because I know every Sunday when I was a kid, my mom and dad used to always wake me up, you know, go to church in the morning. You know,
Growing up in the Tonga community, you get taught about your culture, you know, valuing your traditions, respecting your elders, respecting your family, especially your wife, and, you know, paving a great way for younger generations to follow. It's just sad you had to come down to this, and it's a disappointment to my country that, sweetheart, I'm really sorry that I had to put my hands in. I'm really sorry you had to see that. I'm gonna try to get help, therapy, you know, and hopefully alcohol will no longer be affected in our family.
In our Matai, we wanted to show the various effects of alcoholism on our Pacific people. Alcoholism blinds you from the values you were raised with, whether they were Christian or another system, belief system. Kava is not the only place to learn our cultural values, but alcohol abuse can make us deaf to traditional wisdom that is passed down from generation to generation. Finally, if you continue on this path, alcoholism will find its way to your home and destroy your family.
In the past 5 years, there have been many alcohol-related accidents and deaths. In 2011, there were 12 accidents with 5 fatalities. 2012, 8 fatalities. We come to last year, 2014, there were 6 related accidents caused by alcohol with 3 deaths. This year, so far there have been 7 alcohol-related accidents with 3 fatalities. So, these statistics clearly show that in the past 5 years, there have been many alcohol-related accidents and deaths in our country. This is a serious problem, and we need to find a solution for it.
Here are some solutions. We believe that families be more responsible in educating their children about alcohol abuse at home. We also believe that we should pass on our tradition through oral history, poems, traditional dance, songs, handicrafts, and especially our language. We firmly believe that if these cultural practices are taught within the home, school, and at church, our people will be educated enough to avoid alcoholism.
Regardless of the statistics and facts, it is our own choice as individuals to make the right decision. If we choose to drink, it is up to us to drink responsibly. But if we choose to make the wrong decisions, we will not be able to decolonize ourselves from it and other forms of colonizations that holds us back from our potential. Make the right decision to be a better person, not only for yourself, but for everyone around you.